Hello, my name is John Florence, and I'm the Director of Sales and Marketing here at Xima Software. In this demonstration, we will review Chronicall's recording library. Xima can record calls many different ways, and it will differ based off your PBX type, but the end result is the same. Your recordings are available within our Cradle to Grave program, which makes it easy to use and manage. Let's take a closer look. Now, one of the great things about Chronicall is that you can access all the different software modules through the same interface. This means you can listen to your recordings as well as view the call details. Now, there are a number of different ways to record your calls depending on your phone system, but the end result is the same. You can access them from our Cradle to Grave interface. Within the Chronicall home screen, you can select Listen to Recordings or under Reports, select Cradle to Grave. Select the date you wish to review. You can do a range or just a specific day. You can also use the filter tool to drill down into specific calls, such as calls by particular agent or by group. Once you've selected your filter, go ahead and hit execute. Here are all of your different results for the criteria you selected. Now on the right-hand side, you have your recordings. You may have noticed not every call is being recorded. You get to pick and choose which calls get recorded and how often. Now if you wanted to record every single call, along the right-hand side here, you would see a play button within each of the calls. Once you find the calls that you're looking for, go ahead and press the play button. What will happen is it'll expand the call so you can see all of the call details as it happened in a chronological order. On the bottom, you have this built-in media player where you can listen to your recording as well as see the wave pad of that call so you can see when there was no talking or when talking was occurring, so you can click and drag to the appropriate points. Now, on the right-hand side, you have your menu option. What do you want to do with this recording? Do you want to just listen to it? But you can also download it, email it, generate an external link, which is useful for a couple of reasons. First, let's say you want to send a recording to a customer, but you don't want to send them the actual WAV file. What you can do is just send them a link to the recording, and you can also specify how long that link is valid. So maybe that link is only valid for 5 days. That means they have 5 days to review the call. This is also useful if you want to put recordings into a CRM such as Salesforce. You can send these links to objects created within Salesforce so you can review those recordings within your CRM application. You can also delete the recording based off of permission sets. You can view notes. So if a call has notes associated to it by a manager or an agent, you can review those. For instance, the administrator on July 6th entered, "Ask Jared why he put this customer on park." Jared then responded that same day, "Customer was looking for Jason," and we can review that through the recordings ourselves. You can also create a snippet tool. So maybe you don't want the whole recording, maybe you just want a portion of the call. You can download just a snippet of that call and send that to the customer. You can also do different playback speeds. This is very useful if you're reviewing calls on a regular basis. Let's say, for instance, you have a 40-minute call. Well, you don't want to spend 40 minutes listening to that call. Maybe you only want to spend half the time. Well, you can just speed that call up to 2 times as fast, and then you've cut your review in half. Now, our development team did a great job with this playback speed. Oftentimes, when you play calls faster, it will make them sound a little funny, almost like it sounds like a chipmunk. Within Chronicall, that will not happen. It actually maintains the same pitch or tone of the caller. It just plays it back a lot faster. Now, within the call, you can search for recordings. You can also move the columns around in any order that you prefer. Back within the Chronicall main menu, you also have a few additional options when it comes to recording. You can also score recordings. Within the scorecard campaigns, you can create campaigns to evaluate calls based off agent or based off of group. Here you can see a demo campaign that has 2,038 calls that match or meet this criteria. If I'm the supervisor and I wish to now evaluate and score this recording, I simply hit score and it's going to pull up all of those calls that I need to review. Here you can see I have the same WavePad view of the calls. I have the menu options, but as I'm listening to this call, I can see it's Victor's call and I can evaluate his performance. We have yes/no type questions, 1 through 10 type questions, so overall performance, and you can also put free-form notes or text. All of this data is reportable within the standard reports. You can go on and score those recordings and score the next one. There you can now see I have scored one out of the 2,038 calls. Now, to create a campaign is very easy. You just simply hit Create New Campaign. And again, you do this based off group or agent. If I want to do this off agent, I give it a title. We'll just call this Demo. And then I can select my start date, meaning when do I want to start reviewing calls? When do I want the system to look for the first recording calls? Let's just go ahead and start this July 2nd. I can also set an expiration date. When does this campaign end? If I want it to be ongoing, I'll just leave that blank. Because this is an agent campaign, I'll select my agents. Again, here is the list of all the users within your system. You can determine the scoring amount. Do you want to do a certain amount of calls per agent or percentage? Why don't we do random sampling of 25% of their calls? Now, it's time for you to add your questions. What is it that you want to evaluate the agents on? And there is no limit to the number of questions that you can add to a campaign. You can also set the criteria for the calls you want to meet. This is very important. Say, for instance, you want to evaluate calls based off of your sales team performance. You probably don't want to evaluate calls where they left a voicemail or a very short talking duration. You want them to be on that call for at least maybe 5 minutes. So we can come in here and do call duration has to be greater than 5 minutes. So that way, any call under that time period will not be counted in our evaluations and scorecards. Another feature available within VRTX recording library using VRTX hardware is the ability to view active recordings, which calls are being recorded right now. Here you can see all of my different calls that are currently being recorded, as well as if I ran out of any ports. These are all calls that I should have been recording, that I wanted to record based off my recording rules, but I just don't have enough ports to record those calls. You can also right-click on any of these agents and listen live using our VRTX hardware. So a supervisor can now listen in to his employees' calls to verify that they're doing what you want them to do. To set up which calls get recorded, that is easy to do. You'll just simply come in here and manage recording rules. Simply hit add, and you can record calls based off of the inbound number dialed, external number, agents, which again are your extensions, groups, basic and advanced call events, so a sequence of events. Let's pretend we want to do this based off groups. I can select my groups, again, directly pulled from the phone system. Just select the ones that we want to do, hit OK. How many calls do you want to record? Do you want to record all calls, none, or a certain percentage? Maybe 50% of calls. And then we'll go ahead and give this a title. We'll just call this group. It's just that simple. Now you're going to be able to record your group calls. The last few things that you can do with VRTX recording library is give users the ability to pause the recordings. This means when they get on a call, they can stop that recording if ever they're asked to. You can also use our API to automatically pause the recording based off if they open up a specific application. This is very useful for compliance purposes. If you're in Europe and you need to comply with GDPR, under admin and then privacy tools, you can export the personal data, including the recordings, as well as delete all of their personal data from the database, as well as their recordings. Thank you for watching this demonstration of Chronicall's recording library. If you have any questions or want to learn more, please contact your local Xima reseller or give us a call today.